waking up knowing there's a reason. All my dreams come alive. Life is for living with you. I've made my decision. You lift me up, fill my eyes with wonder. For every young in your love, this freedom's untainted. With you, no moment is wasted.
Love is an ocean, you can drown me. The sweet embrace, the lovely taste I taste and see. I'm under grace, the place to be. It means I'll never need an umbrella. I'm cool in the cold, in the hot weather. Whether or never I ever understand, I'm a man in the hands of great plans. I stand with faith and a life I never known to touch. Instead, I saw my clutch, but I'm like, what's the dream of? What's the hope in? What's the doubt for? Live to no end, this is living. The life I've been given's a gift. If I'm a living, I'm a live with the death. So what's the dream of? What's the hope in? What's the doubt for? And live to no end, this is living. The life I've been given's a gift. If I'm a living, I'm a live with the death. Yeah.
I'm coming back to the start. everyone, and welcome back to Connect Church Online. We're so happy that you are here joining us again today. If this is your first experience at Connect Church, thanks for tuning in. We hope that you're encouraged to find fellowship here with us. Text GUEST at the number below or email us at info@connectedmonton.ca so that we can send you our welcome package. Feel free to post your comments and chat with us during the service. Now, get comfortable and settled in as we worship together.
Connect family. I trust you're all keeping well during this time. All of our kids ministry team leaders have really enjoyed reconnecting with all of your kids on Zoom. If you haven't already set yourself up, hurry up, you're missing out. Every Sunday after our main service, we host our kindergarten to grade 5 class at 11 in the morning on Zoom. So just follow the link that's already been sent to you, and we'll see you after the message.
It's an honor for Pedro and I to come into your home through this online service to share a word of faith and hope with you all.
That's right. It's our honor. But we would like to ask you a favor before we start. If it's your first time watching Connect Church online experience, would you help us to know that you are here? Posting a thumbs up emoji on the comments or on the chat room? We appreciate your help. I want to share today a message with you called Facing Our Fears with Faith. But first, I'm going to ask Ruth to read for us as an introduction on the Gospel of John, chapter 6, verses 16 through 21.
And the word of God goes like this. When evening came, his disciples went down to the lake, where they got into a boat and set off across the lake for Capernaum. By now it was dark, and Jesus had not yet joined them. A strong wind was blowing, and the waters grew rough. When they had rowed 3 or 3.5 miles, they saw Jesus approaching the boat, walking on the waters, and they were terrified. But he said to them, "It is I, don't be afraid." Then they were willing to take him into the boat, and immediately the boat reached the shore where they were heading.
I want to start my message today giving you some background on the 6th chapter of John. The 6th chapter of John opens up with the story of Jesus feeding the 5,000 people with 2 loaves and 2 fish. Afterwards, Jesus sent his disciples on their way, and he went up on the mountain by himself to pray. And then comes the description of the storm. And John tells us on verse 16, when evening came, his disciples went down to the sea or to the lake. When evening came, this was the time of day between twilight and dark. The sun had already gone down over the horizon. The sky would soon be completely dark, black. They push off of the shore and start rowing across the Sea of Galilee. And then verse 17, it says, it was now dark. And verse 18, it says, the sea became rough because a strong wind was blowing. When it says here in verse 17 that it was now dark, I believe it was really dark. Probably you could not see the moon or even not could see the stars, for a storm was brewing and thick dark clouds covered the sky. They couldn't see anything. Have you been or are you in a situation in life right now that feels like this, that only thing you can see is dark clouds all over you? I have good news for you today. Let's keep reading verse 18. It says, a strong wind was blowing. The sea was rough. The waves continually lift their boat high into the air and then will drop them down. And in a great splash of water, which covered the disciples, waves overlapped over the sides to the boat onto the disciples' laps. And then verse 19, it says, then when they had rowed about 3 or 3.5 miles, the disciples were in a boat in the middle of the sea at night, caught up in a terrible storm. And this wasn't a large boat like the one that you could see crossing the Mediterranean Sea. This was a small fishing boat. And during rough seas, water could easily splash in on them. And stormy waves would toss them up and down and could overturn them all into the waters. This was scary. Their lives were in danger. They could have drowned in the sea. They were panicking. Then they look up and they see Jesus walking on the sea toward them. They never saw Jesus walking on the water before. It was frightful seeing this figure of a man walking toward them on the water in the darkness in the midst of a storm. And then verse 19, it says that they were terrified. Probably we can identify ourselves with these disciples. All Christians are disciples of Jesus. We love Jesus and we follow him. And like these disciples were caught up in a terrible storm at sea and they were terrified, we too have to face our fears, because we face terrible situations and storms in life as well. We face all kinds of fears today in our lives. A fear of a financial insecurity, a fear of a virus. Right now we are all faced with a storm that scares us. The storm is called COVID-19, sorry. It is deadly and highly contagious. It has taken the lives of people all over the world. It is in practically every country of the world. It just keeps growing and growing. It seems unstoppable. We are, as a community, all taking measures to keep it down. As you know, most of the public spaces are closed right now, at least for the time being. We are practicing what we call social distancing. Hospitals are having trouble getting enough equipment to meet the demands to care for people. People are stocking up on supplies at home. You can hardly find toilet paper or hand sanitizer or masks or even bottled water in stores. And why is that? Because people are terrified. People are scared. People are afraid. People are even afraid to get around other people. Yes, we too are in a terrible storm and we are terrified. But find comfort in knowing that Jesus is with us. Verse 19 and 20, it says, they saw Jesus walking on the sea and coming near the boat, and they were terrified. But he said to them, it is I, do not be afraid. So many times we feel like we are battling alone, but Jesus comes along and says, do not be afraid. I want us to see some great comforting truths here for you and for me today. Let's see it. First, Jesus knows and he cares that we are in a storm. Jesus was up on that mountain praying, but he had not forgotten his disciples. He was not too busy with God to think about them. Jesus, he looked down from that hill and he saw his disciples out there on the sea, struggling in the middle of a storm, being scared, helpless and hopeless, being tossed and turned into waves, crying out for help. Jesus did ignore them. He looked at them and he cared for them. And then Jesus came towards them. Jesus comes to us. Jesus got up and he walked down the mountain and he headed toward the disciples in their distress. Soon they were able to see Jesus walking on the water coming toward them. The disciples, they were so busy feeling the wind and the rain beating against their faces and not being able to see in the darkness, and water was splashing in on them and pouring over the sides of the boat onto them. At first, they did not see that Jesus was coming toward them. This is why they got scared when suddenly they see Jesus walking near the boat. You and I, we can get so scared with this coronavirus, with all that we are seeing and hearing and experiencing, that we miss seeing that Jesus has not forgotten us. He didn't forget you. That Jesus, you know, he knows the storm that we are going through right now. Jesus loves us and he cares for us. He cares for you, my friend. He has not forgotten us. In fact, he's coming towards us to help us. And he's here right now to help you, to help us. And then Jesus, he spoke. And Jesus said on verse 20, it is I. Do not be afraid. Who is coming across the water to the disciples in their distress? The one that can say, I am. The great I am. Yes, Jesus is God. Jesus is the Lord God, omnipotent. Jesus, the God, the Lord God, all-powerful, all-knowing, ever-present in every situation. During the storm, that night, the disciples, they saw a figure coming, walking across the water toward them, and they may not have recognized him, for they were terrified, they were afraid. They may not, maybe they have wondered, who is that coming towards us? Jesus said, I am, it is I. This same Jesus, who is the great I am, God himself, the Almighty, Creator God, the one that is bigger and stronger than any obstacle we can face in life, who is stronger than any storm we can face, is here with us. During this coronavirus storm, is with you, my friend. And this is good news. This is the answer we need more than any other answer. Jesus is present with us in this storm of life. Once Jesus revealed who he was to his disciples, then he tells them, do not be afraid. He can say, don't be afraid, because he's God. Because he's bigger and stronger than any storm in life. And the fact that he's walking across those stormy waves shows that he is bigger than any stronger storm that you can face. That storm could not beat him down. He's walking on the waves. Since Jesus is bigger and stronger than this storm that we are in right now, then we are going to keep our eyes on him. We are going to trust him. We are going to pray to him. We are going to reach out and get a hold of his hand, because he wants to help us. It is so comforting to know that this great God, this great I am, is with us. And we shouldn't be afraid. Jesus helped them to get through the storm. Verse 21, it says, then they wanted to take him into the boat, and immediately the boat reached the land toward which they were going. Did the storm immediately end when Jesus came to them? No. Did the waves stop pounding? Did the wind stop blowing? Did the sea get all calm and still? No. But they were still in the storm because Jesus guided them through the storm to the other side. The Gospel of John does not say, like other Gospels, that Jesus stilled the storm right away. And I believe that there is a reason why John doesn't mention that specifically. Because John is pointing to the fact that Jesus got into the boat with them, and through that situation, through that storm, Jesus brought them safe to the shore. Are we in a storm? Probably we can agree that and say, yes, we are. Are we afraid? Yes. The miracle is that Jesus, who is the great I am, the Almighty God, he loves us and is with us. And as we cry out to him and trust him, he holds our hand and he leads us through the storm. You don't need to panic. You don't need to be terrified. You don't need to be afraid. It doesn't matter what kind of storm you are facing right now. Jesus is there to walk with you and guide you, giving you strength and wisdom and power to overcome the situation that you are facing, that we are facing. My friend, Jesus never promised the absence of problems. What he did promise was that in the middle of problems, we should take courage. Actually, John 16, verse 33, it says, these things I've spoken to you, Jesus said, that in me you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation, problems, storms, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. My friends, don't walk alone. Don't fight by yourself. Let Jesus come into your heart. Let Jesus come into your life and help you and walk with you. He wants to be part of your life. That's why Jesus said, look, I stand at the door and knock. If you hear my voice and open the door, I will come in and I will share a meal together as friends. Yes, Jesus wants to be your friend, your best friend, actually, and share life with you. He wants to go to come in and sit and have a meal with you. What are you going to do with his invitation? If you want to say yes to his invitation, if you want to say yes to Jesus now, right now, I would like to ask you to pray this simple prayer with me. Repeat after me, saying, Jesus, I repent of my sins. I recognize I'm a sinner and I need forgiveness. And I accept you as my Lord and Savior. Come into my life and make me a new person. Amen. My friend, if you pray this prayer, would you mind to post a prayer and emoji on the comments or on the chat room? Or if you want, you can make it more private and you can email me at info@connectedmonton.ca. Why? Because we want to follow up with you. We want to walk with you on this new journey with Jesus Christ. Myself or someone from our team will be in touch with you to guide you on the next steps on this new walk with Jesus, on this new season, in this new journey of your life. Right now we are going to worship together, singing another song. And then Ruth and I will be back to pray for all of you and pray for the situation that we are living right now. So let's together praise the Lord. As we promised, we are going to pray for you and for the different situations that we are going through right now in our lives. So if you want, join us, because the Bible tells that the prayer of agreement is so powerful. And Ruth and I, we're going to pray in agreement and with you. Okay, so let's pray in agreement together right now.
Yes.
Father God, right now we came into your presence to pray, Lord, for all of this situation that we are going through. And Lord, we know that it's a difficult situation, a tough situation for everyone. But it's not easy for the leaders of the world. It's not easy for the leaders of the nations. And as your word tells us, we want to pray right now for the leaders. They are in authority. We want to pray for the prime minister of this nation. We want to pray, Lord, for all of his cabinet, for the decisions they need to make. We pray for the premier of this province of Alberta and his cabinet as well, for every decision, every law they need to pass, Lord, for the good of the community, Lord. We pray, Lord, for the mayor of the city of Edmonton and surrounding areas, all the mayors in the cities in Alberta, Lord. We pray that they will receive guidance and wisdom from you to make the right decisions for the good of the people. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord, and we also want to join our prayers with everybody that is praying right now, Lord, and we pray specifically for the doctors,
yes,
for the nurses, for everybody that is helping the hospitals, Father. They need your protection. They need to be covered by your protection, Lord. So we pray that you protect them all, Lord. Be with them. Keep them safe and strong and healthy so they can help in fighting over this disease, Father. Yes. We pray that you cover everybody with the blood of Jesus, because there is power in the blood of Jesus and there is protection in it, Lord. So we pray for those health, yes, workers, Lord, the frontline workers, Lord. Be with them, protect them, Father, and may they experience safety. May they experience your peace upon their hearts, upon their minds. May they trust you and just declare your word over them, Father. We pray, Lord, in Jesus' name.
Yes, Lord. I want to pray as well, Father, for all the people that have been infected by this coronavirus. Even we want to pray for the families that already lost their loved ones. We pray for the encouragement of the Holy Spirit upon them. The ones that are in the bed of a hospital or receiving care, we pray that you will heal them, Lord. I pray strength upon their bodies, for their immune system, Lord. Lord, we know, we believe that you can defeat this virus, Lord. So give strength to the people that have been infected so they can recover 100% and a quick recovery in Jesus' name, Father.
Amen, Lord. Yes, and we also want to pray for your church all over the world, but specifically the church where we serve you, Lord, Connect Church.
Yes.
We pray for our brothers and sisters there. We pray that you keep them all in your care, every family, every couple, every girl, every boy, every child. Father, we pray protection over your people at Connect Church, Lord. May they grow closer to you in these hard times.
Yes,
may they,
Lord,
take more time to be with you, talking to you, receiving your strength, receiving your encouragement, just spending more time in your word, because that's where we get our comfort, that's where we get our hope. And we pray that hope be bigger than fear.
Amen.
We pray for hope to be greater than fear in the hearts of your people at Connect Church, Lord. Strengthen every family. Strengthen every couple, every child, Lord. Because there is hope in you. There is hope in your word, Lord. When we take time to read your word, we feel encouraged. We feel uplifted. And we feel and we experience the peace of God that surpasses all understanding. Your word says that there is no fear in love, but perfect love, which is the love,
yes,
of God,
yes,
it casts out,
yes,
all the fear.
Yes.
You also tells us in 2 Timothy 1:7 that you didn't give,
yes,
us the spirit of fear,
amen,
but,
amen,
you gave us the spirit of power and,
yes,
love,
amen,
and of a sound mind.
Thank,
and that's,
Father,
what we choose. That's what we receive, the spirit of God that strengthens us and makes us to live in faith and not in fear,
amen,
Lord. We pray this prayer and we believe that very soon we're going to live freely again,
yes,
and this virus will be extinguished and will be eradicated out of this planet. And we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
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 And we want to pray as well for you that eventually today made a decision to follow Jesus as your Lord and Savior. If you did that decision at home, we want to pray for you right now. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for my new brothers and sisters that made a decision today to follow you, that repent today, that decided to accept Jesus as their Lord and Savior. I pray that they will experience the new spiritual birth, and I pray that we'll start a new life, Lord. The Bible tells us that, you know, the old is gone, the old is past. Now it's a new life, now it's a new season in Christ Jesus. And I pray, Lord, that they will experience the health and the blessings and the strength and the anointing of the Holy Spirit upon their lives as they start this new journey with you, Lord. So give them the strength that they need right now. In the name of Jesus, we pray. And we pray believing that everything we pray, we receive. Amen and amen.
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 Hello, Connect Church. This is a message for all the Rise Youth.
Unfortunately, we can't be together, but we have something preparing you on Zoom. So join us there. Let's have a good time and, yeah, join us.
Yeah, so every Sunday after the online service at 11 a.m., join us on Zoom. You can use your tablet, your phone, your computer, any of those devices. If you have any troubles logging on or joining, let us know. You can email us at riseyouth@connectedmonton.ca or follow the links provided. So hope to see you on Sunday.
See you soon.
We are so thankful for your ongoing financial support during the last few weeks. Even though we cannot meet in person, if you're wondering how you can support Connect Church financially, there are three options that you can choose from. Through online giving on our website at connectedmonton.ca/give, via e-transfer to info@connectedmonton.ca, or by mailing a check to the address listed below. If you are a first-time guest, or if you have decided to accept Jesus today, we encourage you to go onto our website, click on the menu, then contact us, then connect. Fill out your information, then submit it, and take your first step on your path to Jesus. Under the same contact us section as well, you will find the prayer request option. Here you can submit any prayer requests and our team will pray for you. Looking for a way to connect during the week? Join a small group. You can find the information below or email us at info@connectedmonton.ca. Thank you for joining us today. We will be back here again next Sunday for another online experience. Have a blessed Sunday and an awesome week. God bless.